one thing I've noticed is that one of the ways in which I know that I am finding truths out is that problem is solved for good.
That's exactly right.
I don't have to revisit that same problem again. Because that problem is solved for good, both my internal state and my external state, quote unquote, improve. They change. Improve is a big word. So the more they change, internally, I'm quieter, and externally, my life is less complicated.
You have brought up a seminal point, which is it is not about the journey. It absolutely is about the destination. You want to get to the point where you don't have it anymore. You aren't looking for treatments. You're looking for a cure. There is a destination. It isn't about spending the next 90 years getting assaulted and then feeling better, getting assaulted and putting Tiger Balm on it. It is about wanting to get over it. Destinations and journeys, that's another lie. It's not about journeys. It's about destinations. Now, destinations require journeys, but everything that you do in your life is defined by the destination. The moment that you leave your house every single day, you have a destination, and the destination creates the avenue.
This is one of those social lies where everyone says it's about the journey is the reward. Yeah, the journey is the thing that you're actually on. That's where you are right now. But if you don't get to a destination, you've sort of wasted your time.
Well, if there was no destination, no one would begin any journey. If there was no compulsion to arrive anywhere, then nobody would begin any kind of journey at all. It is just that most people's destination is the prescription, wearing the orange colored robe and then sitting in front of the incense and having the self-image that I'm a yogi and that I am meditating and I'm doing all the spiritual things. And that becomes a destination in itself, that I have achieved that self-image where I view myself that way.
So what is a worthy destination?
Oh, there is no worthy. It is not about enforcing rules. There are no rules. Rules are to be avoided at all costs if one is sincere, because wherever there's a rule, there's insincerity. It's like stoicism. It's a rule. It can't go anywhere. It's more self-image creation. Everything begins with the truth. What is the truth? The truth is that in a human being's life, he has problems. That's the truth. In a human being's life, he has specific problems. Some problems that are more acute for him than for his neighbor. His most acute problems are his living reality. They're not abstract. They're not spiritual. They are in his face, and he lives in that every single day. That is where to begin.
So one begins very concretely with one's own problems. There are real problems that everybody faces. And if you have a genuine desire to solve these problems once and for all, the way to do them is not to follow some routine or build up some image of the person who solves problems. It's to examine them for the truth, no matter how unpopular or how untransmissible or unexplainable it might be. And if you look for the truth and you find it, you'll know you found it when you've solved the problem.
And if we go back to zero for a second, zero is the understanding that problems can be solved forever. Society believes in journeys. Society believes in endless treatments forever. Practice, 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 practice forever. When the whole game has been set up to practice forever, then there is no conclusion. There is no arrival of anything.
There's a way for people to see that. If you look at how we think about spirituality and solving problems internally, it is considered to be, oh, I'm just going to work on it forever. I'm going to go see a therapist forever. I'm going to meditate forever. I'm going to read forever. I'm going to talk to a counselor or to a coach forever. I'm going to work on it. I'm on the path. I'm on the journey. But if you go into very practical things like making money, nobody says, I'm going to work forever. No, they're like, I want to make a pile of money, right? If I'm starting a company, I want the company to be successful. I want the company to go public or to get acquired or to generate so much cash flow that while I'm still alive, I can spend that cash. In the money-making context, we're extremely practical. We want to make that money while we're still young enough and alive enough to spend it. But in the internal context, we get all spiritual and start talking about maybe the next life, maybe in heaven or in hell or in my reincarnated life, or I'm just going to keep doing my self-work and my self-improvement until the day I die. And it's considered acceptable to never arrive at a destination.
There's a very simple truth as to how to arrive at getting over your problems without having to lift a finger.
You've got my ears.
It's all about exposure. If a person sat on his couch for the next 50 years, his internal environment, from his mind to his brain, everything within him, is a direct resonance. It's like a tuning fork. It responds to the inputs, same as a microphone. If that human is exposed to truth on a regular basis, his ears don't even have to hear it consciously. Something inside of him will internalize that truth, and that will become his new norm. A human being becomes his environment, and that is why it's absolutely critical to savagely and surgically arrange one's environment in a way that is in accordance with where he wants to go. No one does that. If a person is exposed to truth on a regular basis, now not prescription, it's got to be straight truth, then that becomes his norm. That becomes the way that he thinks. His brain begins to rewire itself. There isn't a single amount of work that needs to be done. There isn't a single amount of psychotherapy that needs to be done. No medications. The human body treats itself. It all depends upon the input. It is all about one thing and one thing only: exposure. You become that which you are most consistently exposed to.
In a modern context, the people who are very interested in truth and in conquering the mind and in internal freedom tend to coalesce on reading the same books, thinking about the same things, listening to the same podcasts, talking to the same people. And even though prescriptions don't work and no book is going to make you conquer the mind and listening to any podcast is not going to give you internal freedom, eventually at some point it does soak in. You're attracted to what you want to be. And as you immerse yourself in it, you have no choice but to become that over time. It's like in wealth creation. If you want to start a company, you go to Silicon Valley or you go to a pool of entrepreneurs and you spend enough time around them. You hang around the tech business long enough and you'll be in the tech business. You hang around a bunch of techies, you'll be talking tech all day. So we're naturally drawn to certain things, and if we can immerse ourselves in them, it creates inevitability to the future.
And to take it to the next level, it's about titrating that environment. Because any environment from Silicon Valley to anywhere else, while it has the benefits, it will also have the detriments. It's about titrating out all that is not wanted and titrating in all that is. It can very much be fine-tuned like a buffet.